Update 33 has introduced some controversial features to the game, so in this video, we will discuss how Undead Labs can slightly alter those features before the public release to make this the most welcoming update of State of Decay 2. If you don't know anything about Update 33, learn its current state before watching this video, otherwise you won't understand a thing. First, let's address the problems that are present in the Infestations revamp. Number 1. Morale is the primary reason most players hate infestations. Since we now have two types of infestations, only the siege infestation should affect our morale because it only has solid reasons to make our community sad. Number 2. Play hearts should not simply send infestation hordes to infect random buildings. They should farm infestations to their proximity buildings to protect themselves from us. Once we wake up a play heart, its first priority should be farming the proximity infestations. There should be a number and radius limit for the proximity infestations, and only after the limit is reached, the play heart should send infestation hordes to farm siege infestations near our base. Now let's address the problems that are present in the play heart's awakening mechanics. Number 1. We learned that play hearts sometimes will wake up themselves. Not sure whether it is intentional or a bug, but definitely it should not be a thing. Number 2. Once a play heart wakes up, it will start to release infestation hordes, so we are motivated to destroy that heart. But destroying one heart in a cluster will wake up the proximity hearts, which is extremely unmotivating to destroy one. Number 3. Stealth killing the zombies also wakes up the play hearts, but this undermines the value of stealth, so it should be changed. Number 4. We learned that Screamer Scream can wake up the play hearts, but it is something not in the player's control, so no matter how careful a player is, a screamer will scream at some point, which will wake up a play heart. Most importantly, screamers are known to trigger other screamers, so even if we are not inside any plague territory, one screamer will trigger another one that is inside a territory, which will wake up the play heart. Instead, it can be made that a few screams inside a plague territory can wake up the play heart. Number 5. If we look at the play heart's awakening data chart, it shows that killing only 3 freak zombies inside a plague territory will wake up the play heart in lethal zone. Most importantly, killing only 6 plague zombies with our vehicles will wake up the play heart. It does not make lethal zone hard, but only makes it frustrating. So instead of making everything related to our difficulty settings, things like this should be made the same across all the difficulties. Now let's address the problems that are present in the siege mechanics revamp. A 3-way siege usually takes 6 plus minutes to be over, which is painfully long. Siege hordes of each wave take at least a minute to reach our base, so the waiting period between each wave is extremely long and boring. The waiting period is even longer if you are living in isolated bases like the farmland compound and more distributing. Instead of having multiple waves in a siege, it can be made that all the siege infestations should simply release their occupants towards our base and despawn. A 3rd level siege infestation will usually have a juggernaut, a few ferals, screamers, bloaters and zombies, so facing them is not going to be easy. Also, the siege hordes from each infestation will arrive our base at different times, so we won't be flooded with all the zombies at the same time. A siege like this will be quick, less complicated and less boring. And finally, the good news is, Undead Labs has told us that the root cause of this deadliest glitch has been found and it has been fixed.